Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Lancer Aquatic Center on the campus of California Baptist University for semifinal Saturday at the 2022 Golden Coast Conference Women's Championships. Game 7 is our first semifinal and features number 2 Pacific taking on number 3 Loyola Marymount. The Golden Coast Conference and our 8 competing institutions are committed to the ideals of good sportsmanship and fair play. We ask all persons to show respect for the opposing team, game officials, and each other. Persons throwing objects or participating in other acts in conflict with good sportsmanship and fair play are subject to ejection. Your cooperation is greatly appreciated. And now, let's meet our starting lineups. First, wearing the white caps in today's game, the Lions of Loyola Marymount. In goal, number 1A, Madison Davis. The 2-meter, number 3, Yana Gerber. At 2 meter, number 4, Molly Williams. At utility, number 5, Elena Sanchez. At utility, number 9, Kelsey Snellgart. At attacker, number 11, Maria Elena Salatopoulou. And at attacker, number 12, Ruth Arino Ruiz. Head coach for the Lions is Kyle Witt. And wearing the dark caps in today's game are the Pacific Tigers. In goal, number 1, Clara Volpisi. At attacker, number 3, Tula Falvi. At attacker, number 5, Mariana Duarte. At 2 meter, number 6, Brianna Utis. At utility, number 8, Emma Mayall. At attacker, number 10, Anna Martinez Duamaral. And at attacker, number 12, Lucy Davis. Head coach for the Tigers is James Graham. Officials for our first semifinal are Peter Sopamisai and Haas Ortega. Gold judges are Victoria Mizak and Mike Stewart. Ladies, 2 minutes to game time. Information, including our Tournament Insider digital program at gccwaterpolo.com. Get stats, rosters, and more only at gccwaterpolo.com.
From the Lancer Aquatic Center in Riverside, it's semifinal action of the 2022 Golden Coast Conference Women's Water Polo Championships. Our first semifinal day is the number 2 seed Pacific Tigers against the number 3 seed, the Loyola Marymount Lions. Good afternoon, everyone. Delighted to have you along today. I'm Travis Fianotti. This is a highly anticipated match between Pacific and LMU. Should be a great one. Yesterday, Pacific beat Concordia 14-8 to advance, and LMU beat Santa Clara 9-4 to get to this point. The winner of this one plays the winner of Fresno State, San Diego State, the 1-4 coming up next in the championship game tomorrow at 1 p.m. So we've had two games already today. In the seventh place game, CBU beat Concordia Irvine 13-10. That was a great game. And then the fifth place game right before this one, Azusa Pacific outlasted Santa Clara 13-12. So we've had two good games to begin, and we expect this one to be an absolute barn burner. The starting goalies, first of all, for Pacific, Clara Volpisi. So Volpisi started yesterday and made 6 saves in giving up those 8 goals against Concordia. And for LMU, it's Madison Davis, no surprise. She started yesterday as well for LMU against Santa Clara, and she made 6 saves in giving up just 4 goals. Well, so glad you're along with us on the CBU Lancers YouTube channel. Lions and Tigers, oh my, to start off the semifinals. Well, here we go.
On the opening sprint for the Tigers, number 8, Emma Mayall.
And the opening sprint is won by Emma Mayall.
Mayall takes it for Pacific.
Now the opening possession for Pacific. Brianna Utas to the side. In the regular season on April 1st, Pacific beat LMU 12-11. Oh, just a 1-goal game. As it is stolen by LMU. The Pacific 7-1 in GCC play during the season. For LMU, 5-2 to earn the number 3 seed. Ruth Arino Ruiz. Arino Ruiz draws an ordinary foul on Mariana Duarte. 50-50 ball, again, stays with LMU. Played across for Arino Ruiz. Into the hole. And we got a penalty throw.
Penalty called on Pacific.
So just 48 seconds in. The penalty is on Utah's. So this will be Marielena Stella Topoli. Topolu, and she scores.
And your goal, number 11, Marielena Stella Topoli.
Stella Topoli opens the scoring on the penalty throw. So nice shot there by Marielena. So let's Topolu. And Pacific looks to answer back. It's Kila Kutarina. To Rion to the side. All the way back for Mariana Duarte. Duarte shoots and it's stopped by Davis. Oh, Duarte, who scored four goals against LMU in that regular season game, robbed there by Madison Davis. Arena Ruiz scored five goals in that game for LMU. And she scored five of LMU's 11 goals as that ball is stolen by Mile. And it's picked up by Vulpisi. Good defense there by Pacific. Duarte had the only goal of the fourth quarter in that game, which allowed Pacific to beat LMU. Volpizzi and Davis started those games in the cages as well for Pacific and LMU. Volpizzi made nine saves while Davis made six saves. I've got an exclusion. Though Molly Williams heads off and Pacific gets the first power play of the game. And area pass, it's turned over to LMU. A quick kill for the Lions on that offensive foul. And Molly Williams now with the ball. Plays ahead. This is Arena Ruiz. And she is a pure goal scorer, Arena Ruiz. Kelsey Snellgar to the side. Now 5 seconds to shoot for Snellgar. Snellgar is going to have to hurry. And it goes off of the post. Well, PC got up just enough. It didn't matter, hit the post anyway. Approaching the 5 minute mark of the opening quarter. Futurian. Futurian, a shot over the cage. Well, the ball stays with Pacific as well. Well, the University of the Pacific in Stockton, California, LMU in Los Angeles. Another exclusion on LMU. Yana Gerber goes off this time. So back-to-back power plays for Pacific. There's Fruta Rian hits it off of the post. She's had the ball a lot early on. Hila Futurian. Now it's Mile into the hole. Double team there for LMU. Draws an ordinary foul. Catch and shoot for the goal. Tula Falvey. It's the power play goal, and the game's tied at 1 at 4:22. Beautiful catch and shoot there from Pacific. I'm going to say that expired just at the end of the power play there. So an even strength goal, but still. Falvey gets the equalizer. Arena Ruiz draws some contact by Falvey. And it's turned over to Pacific. LMU, another offensive foul. As Clara Vulpizzi handles. Area pass. And LMU kind of got up high there. But then an offensive foul on Pacific. Now here come the Lions. Long lob. It's a two-on-one potentially. And Sela Topolu is whistled. And Pacific goes the other way. Chaos the last couple of possessions. As Duarte handles for Pacific. Artoy all the way across. Quick pass and they score again. Back-to-back goals the exact same way. Falvey again. Loose in front, the catch and shoot, and Pacific has the lead. And goal just 57 seconds later. Some changes for LMU. Tula Falvey. Real good start for Pacific. And we're expecting this one to maybe go down to the wire. Well, Falvey had a hat trick against LMU earlier. Duarte, four goals, and Falvey with a hat trick against the Lions back on April 1st. They already got a pair. Arena Ruiz bumped. Arena Ruiz to the side, and it's a lob goal for LMU. Now they do to Pacific what Pacific did to them. Molly Williams, nice lob shot to get it by Volpici. Just 34 seconds later, the ball game is tied up again. The team's kind of following the same playbook. Getting a player loose in front of the cage. And just sending it there for a quick shot. To Rian, but again, Pacific turns it over. Play to the side by Tara, the Braybander. Going all the way in, another lob shot goes in, but there was a foul before that. It was in front of the cage. So no goal for LMU. Mile. A bit of contact, ball stays with Pacific. Mile again to Duarte. Just going back and forth here at the Lancer Aquatic Center. Under two to play. So it's a Polu. And exclusion in front of the cage.
Exclusion on number six, Pacific.
Well, Utah's heads off. That's her second already.
Eight,
now they're going to give it to Mile, actually. So Miles first. Well, the first power play now for LMU. This is May Villanova. To the side, even, as the shot is stopped by Volpici. And timeout called by Pacific.
Timeout is called by Pacific. Full timeout.
Actually, a 30-second timeout. Well, Pacific uses their 30-second timeout early on. Well, LMU opened the scoring on a penalty throw from Sela Topolu. And back-to-back goals from Falvey. And LMU answers back with Molly Williams. As the Braybander comes out of the pool for LMU. And 1:22 to go in the opening quarter. First of two semifinals. Guterian fouled. A mile to the side. That time that pass in front doesn't work, and it's picked up by Davis. And it quickly goes back the other way for Pacific. Lots of fouls away from the ball in this one. Through to Rian. To Duarte. Ordinary foul. 50 seconds to play. And a lob shot goes off of the post, and it's kept out by Davis. Madison Davis able to bring it back before it drifts across the goal line. Villanova. Villanova sends on to Aria Ruiz. Arena Ruiz all the way across. A 12-second difference, game clock to shot clock. 22 seconds to play. Villanova. Quick shot, but it goes in off of Volpizzi. Alina Sanchez. Sanchez able to just power that one by Clara Volpizzi. 16 seconds. And LMU's got the lead back with 16 seconds to play. And a goalie switch. Ana Martinez do Amaral comes in for Volpizzi. Seven on six going to be up the pool for Pacific. As Duarte has the ball. Able to get it to Guterian. Guterian with 5 seconds. Guterian's got to take a shot. Last second bid by Miles, fought off by Davis, and that's the way the first quarter comes to a close. Strong end for LMU. They're up 3-2 as we head to break. Welcome back to the Lancer Aquatic Center in Riverside. I'm Travis Van Odie. Start of the second quarter, first semifinal of the game. Number 3 seed LMU up on the number 2 seed Pacific 3-2. It was a penalty throw to open the scoring. Marielena Silatopoulou picks up her third goal of the tournament. But then back-to-back goals from Tula Falvey made it 2-1 Pacific. Well, Falvey now has 7 goals. She had 5 yesterday for Pacific. She had 5 of their 8 goals overall. Or 14, rather, beg your pardon. A real good tournament for Falvey continues, but then back-to-back goals from LMU. Williams, her second of the tournament, followed by Sanchez, her second. Pacific 0 for 2 on the power play, LMU 0 for 1. The sprint is won by Mile. The Miles won both sprints. Shots, 7 to 5, favor Pacific. Spot in the championship game tomorrow on the line. Pacific has won 3 GCC championships. LMU has won 2. The Pacific had won 3 straight, 2017, 2018, and 2019. They haven't made it back to the championship game. There's only been 1 since, of course, 2019 for Pacific. LMU, they lost 2 of those, the final 2 championship games to Pacific in 2018 and 2019. So this is a rivalry that's been built in the GCC. A lot of space for Areno Ruiz. And Ruiz has just a little bit of contact. Ruiz across. Outside bid, bar down, but didn't go LMU's way. A real good look. It just didn't get the bounce. 1 minute gone by in the second quarter. Again, LMU, they won their championships in 2014 and 2015, both against San Diego State. Then San Diego State beat Pacific in 2016. Then Pacific, that 3-year run where they beat San Diego State, then LMU back-to-back. Of course, last year, Fresno State beat San Diego State for the GCC championship. The two former champions looking to get back on top here in LMU and Pacific, with Pacific winning one more title, 3, than LMU's 2. They've been part of the class of the GCC for years, Pacific and LMU, as that ball is stolen by Duarte. Spot the national tournament in Ann Arbor, Michigan on the line this week here in Riverside. Concordia Irvine finishes 8th. California Baptist finishes 7th. Santa Clara finishes 6th, and Azusa Pacific finishes 5th. Futurian, an outside bid just wide. Good look there for Gila Futurian. LMU back with possession. 5:55 to play in the first half. Game's been tied twice. There have been 1 lead change. Play to Mia Solorzano. That's Kelsey Snelger, actually. And it's turned over to Pacific. Well, Snelger had possession, but a foul away from the ball. The Volpizzi handles. Duarte. Duarte to Mile. And quickly ahead. A little bit of contact. Utah's. Just marvel at Pacific's passing. Strong passing club. You see Davis a shot off the post, and it's kept out by Davis. But Davis robbed by Davis. Could be a 2-on-1 if LMU hurries. Gerber plays into the middle for Snelger. Try and get 2 players in front, LMU. Meanwhile, a foul up top. Little area pass and a tug draws an exclusion.
Exclusion called on Pacific's number 3.
Falvey off for the first time. LMU's second power play, they're 0 for 1. Snelger. Catch and shoot, bar down. Gerber.
LMU goal, number 3, Jana Gerber.
What a shot by Yana Gerber. Bar down this time for the Lions. Mackerel comes at 4:26. Three straight goals for the Lions. That's the first power play goal of the game. LMU is 1-for-2. Substitutions also for the Lions. Now Pacific needs a surge. This game's been controlled by LMU over the last 6 minutes or so. Turian gets it back. An exclusion. And a skip shot goes in. But no, it was
exclusion call on LMU's number 13. 17 correction.
Too soon. As the exclusion was on Maddie Galt. Offensive foul negates the goal scored. As Pacific is now over 3 on the power play. Oh, nicely done. Right in the middle of the pool. Arena Ruiz picks up her 6th goal of the season against Pacific. And that was a beautiful one. First 2 goals of the quarter from LMU. About 53 seconds apart. That's now 4 straight goals for the Lions. One job there by Ruth Arena Ruiz to kind of keep her balance, so to speak, and fire that one home. Arena Ruiz, her 2nd goal of the tournament. Again, she has owned Pacific this year. Anna Martinez Duamiral. All the way across. Got a foul on the near side. Pacific continues to commit fouls with the ball. Approaching the 3-minute mark of the first half. Snellger's got some space. Plays to Arena Ruiz. Pacific's got to shore up the hole a little bit. They're allowing LMU to get a lot of balls in there. Now this time an offensive foul on LMU. Now the tugging foul. Two and a half to play. Utah's shot stopped by Davis. And an exclusion on Pacific. Timeout, LMU.
Exclusion called on Pacific's number 6, and a timeout called by LMU.
The Utah's now heads off on her 2nd. A big power play coming up for LMU. That's the first timeout called by LMU, a full timeout. A 2-1 Pacific. And then Molly Williams scored to make it 2-2. Just before the end of the first quarter, it was Sanchez making it 3-2 LMU. And the Lions have had the better of the play in this second quarter, getting both goals from Gerber, and then Arena Ruiz. 4 straight goals for LMU. In full control this one at the moment. Pacific needs a stop here to kind of prevent this one from getting too far away. Beautiful day for water polo here in Riverside. Hope you're enjoying it on the CBU Lancers YouTube channel. We've had 2 great games already. CBU beating Concordia Irvine 13-10, and Azusa Pacific beating Santa Clara 13-12. Again, power play for LMU. Williams to the side. Snelger to the side of the net, and they score again. They just keep going back to that play. And again, it's Alanda Sanchez. It's her second of the game. Comes at 2:05. This one's starting to be a runaway for LMU. Five straight goals. We've got an exclusion on Sanchez. So she scores the goal and now heads off Pacific's fourth power play. They're 0 for 3. That was an even strength goal for Sanchez, by the way. Power play had just expired. Pacific really needs a goal here, and they get it. From Martinez to Amaral. Martinez to Amaral, her second goal of the tournament. Finally breaks up that stretch for LMU. Anna Martinez to Amaral found the open side of the cage. Lopezzi comes out to snag it. A big minute five now for Pacific. Long lob to Martinez to Amaral. Side of the net's picked off by LMU. Now the Pacific coach is credited with a yellow card. Wanted an exclusion in front. So Kyle Witt, the head coach, giving a yellow card. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Silatopoulou worked around this way for Snelger. She scores! Just as the shot clock expired.
LMU goal number 9, Kelsey Snelger.
Oh, what a shot by Kelsey Snelger. There's 22 seconds left. Timeout called. A big bounce back goal there from LMU to get the four goal cushion back. And Pacific calls timeout. So they have two full timeouts left. And a quarter dominated by LMU. Got a cap change as well, so Utah's now wearing cap 1A. What a shot by Snelgar, though, moments ago, just as the shot clock expired, her first goal of the tournament. Pacific needs a goal here with 22 seconds to play. Go, go, go. They've got 7-on-6 up the pool. Pacific. The shot is stopped by Davis. Duarte had an open look. Remember, there's an open cage. 5 seconds. One last bid, and they get it. Well, Pacific gambles. They pull the keeper, and Gerber makes her pay with a last second goal. Well, 8-3 LMU as we are at the half. Welcome back to the Lancer Aquatic Center in Riverside. I'm Travis Vandote. Start of the second half, first semifinal today. That was a rough first half for Pacific as they trail LMU 8-3. Now LMU, their last two goals scored. First it was a shot clock buzzer beater and then a game clock buzzer beater. So Kelsey Snelger with 22 seconds left. Got the shot clock beater. And then with just 1 second left with the goalie pulled, LMU able to get the ball, and Gerber put it into the wide open cage. So Pacific gambles, but they lose in pulling Clara Volpezzi. The Pacific 0 for 4 on the power play. LMU is 1 for 3. Shots are 13-11 in favor of Pacific. Lots of work to do for the Tigers. Good start there from Marina Duarte. Duarte just 23 seconds in. Certainly a needed goal there for Pacific. Mariana Duarte, her third goal of the tournament. Turned over to Pacific. We have an exclusion as well, looks like. Well, that one's on Arena Ruiz. That's her first. And Pacific's fifth power play. They have scored a goal right after a penalty expired. Davis up top to Puterian. Duarte, who just scored, back across, 6-on-6. Shot by Futurian's blocked by the defenseman. And play to Davis. Another successful kill for LMU. Winner of this one plays the winner of Fresno State, San Diego State, coming up next in the championship tomorrow at 1. They missed opportunity there for Pacific. Didn't get a shot while on the power play. Did get one opportunity, though. Ordinary foul on the Tigers. Play into the middle, just off of the fingertips. And it's taken away by Duarte. Mile. Mile has a couple of players set up front. LMU triple teams, and the shot never gets on the cage. North Pacific just a straight rush that time, didn't set it up. LMU too many players back. Nice move there. 15. And exclusion in front.
Exclusion called on Pacific, number 14.
The Futurian heads off. Now LMU's fourth power play, they're 1 for 3. Now Utah's has 2 for Pacific. Nobody on LMU has more than 1. Deflected just wide. That went off of Pacific, so it stays with LMU. Two seconds left on the power play. Catch and shoot off at a crossbar. Back to even as Williams plays up top. Got a lot on that shot. Sell it to Polu. Open the scoring with a penalty throw goal. Sanchez dishes it in front. A lob shot goes over the cage. Looks like Williams with the opportunity. Pacific strong defense here in the third quarter, but they need goals. 4:35 to go, an exclusion. Arena Ruiz, that's her second. And Pacific right back to the power play. Davis up top to Futurian. Futurian takes the shot and it deflects wide. Just as the 6-on-5 expires. Fresh 35 for Pacific. Kuterian. Let's see if she takes it again. Goes over the cage. Now two looks for Hila Kuterian. One deflected and one a little bit too high. Villanova plays across the pool. Bend to the middle, and Williams dumps it home.
Alley-oop goal scored by number 4, Molly Williams.
That's Williams' second of the game at 3:47. Well, one goal apiece here in the third quarter. That's just fine as far as LMU's concerned. Another second 5-goal lead. The Pacific still looks for more offense against LMU. That's picked up by Kuterian. Outside bid is stopped by Madison Davis. Not a whole lot of quality shots on Davis. That's kind of a disappointing possession for Pacific. Outside bid, low probability. So now LMU looks for more. Offensive foul. Pacific's got numbers up the pool if they can get the ball there. They do. Kuterian kicks it out to Davis. A Pacific's setup as Galt is whistled on the exclusion. That's Galt's second. Pacific's third power play of the quarter. Martinez Duhamer, who has a goal. Here's Kuterian, but again she misses. Hila Kuterian continues to get looks. Still no goals for her in this one. 2:25 to play in the third quarter. Wide open net, but it was deflected wide. Well, Pacific catches a break. See if they can make LMU pay. Davis, wide open. Martinez Duhamel, just getting her fingertips on it. Davis. 2 minutes to go. Sanchez. A little bit of contact from Kuterian. Sanchez all the way across. Yeah, good steal there from Kuterian. Ball played to Volpizzi. One and a half to go in the third quarter. LMU content just to trade possessions like this with no goals. Davis, a lob shot off the post. It's picked up by LMU. Lions' cap fell off. Let's see if LMU just runs a defensive possession here. Villanova with the ball. Villanova's being hounded by Mile. Williams to the side. And it's taken back by Pacific. 7 second difference, game clock to shot clock, 35 seconds to play. Futurian to an open part of the pool, and that's just a turnover to LMU. And now a break for the Lions. It's a one-on-one. And it goes off of the crossbar.
Timeout
called by Pacific.
I'm
going to reset the clock to 12 seconds as well. That was Snelger with the opportunity moments ago on a breakaway. Tried to go perhaps bar down there. The Pacific only has one full timeout left. Meanwhile, LMU's got two full and their 32nd available. It was 3-2 LMU after one. Pacific led this game at one point 2-1 after LMU opened the scoring. Five straight goals scored by LMU. Put them up 6-2. And the Lions haven't looked back since. Big story in this game is Pacific's inability to score 6-on-5. They're 0 for 7. While LMU... only four power plays, but they have scored on one of them. And have gotten a penalty throw goal as well. So LMU taking advantage of what's been given to them. Meanwhile, Pacific really has not. Davis has the ball to Futurian. 1 second, and the shot's blocked. So another strong defensive set for LMU late in the quarter. 8 minutes to play in this first semifinal, 9-4 Lions. fourth quarter of the first semifinal of the day here at the GCC Water Polo Championships. This has been all LMU in this one. Kind of surprising. It's been kind of lopsided in favor of LMU. 2-3 matchup. LMU, they scored five straight goals to make a 2-1 Pacific lead, a 6-2 LMU lead, and the Lions haven't looked back since. It was 3-2 after one, 8-3 LMU at halftime, and each team traded a goal in that third quarter. So Pacific is 0-7 on the power play, which has been a story for the Tigers in this one. And LMU 1-4. Shots are 23-16 in favor of Pacific as well. Now Pacific has had their opportunities, both in terms of just sheer shots on goal and 6-on-5 opportunities. But those two at the end of the half, they still kind of loom large for LMU. The goal with 22 seconds to go, beating the shot clock, and then with 1 second to go, with the goalie out for Pacific. And this time the sprint's won by Sanchez. Pacific had won the previous sprints. That's a big one to open the quarter for LMU. Now LMU 8 minutes away from getting back to the GCC championship game. Outside bit is fought off by Volpizzi. And the last time LMU made the championship game was 2019. They lost to this Pacific team 13-9. Pacific looking to potentially make it four out of the last five tournaments, winning it. Well, Williams, who's got a pair for LMU. We also have a pair from Sanchez and Gerber. LMU has spread the scoring around in this one. The ball is stolen by Guterian. And now the LMU head coach given a yellow card. So both coaches have received a yellow card in this one. So here comes Mile. Mile needs some help, draws contact. And this is Utah's. Davis back up top. Guterian to the side. Lob shot off of the post. And a loose ball goes LMU's way. Duarte was saying her hands were up, but the ref disagrees. 6.5 to play. Pacific really can't afford to come up empty anymore. They're sending a cherry picker up the pool. Pacific, it's Duarte. Meanwhile, an ordinary foul on the Tigers. And now two Tigers are up the pool. They're hoping to get a steal here and a quick pass. Again, LMU with it, just 6 seconds to shoot. Williams takes a lob shot, and she scores. What a pretty goal by Molly Williams. That's the hat trick for Williams. She's got the last two goals of the game as a yellow card issued as well. All this coming at 6:09. So 10-4 LMU, as again Pacific gambled, sending two players into the offensive part of the pool. And then Molly Williams, the soft touch for the hat trick goal. It's just everything that Pacific has tried in this game has kind of not worked out for them. Pulling the goalie, sending two cherry pickers up the pool on that last goal, as it's kept out by Madison Davis. Seems like the luck is kind of going with LMU in this one. Approaching the 5.5 minute mark. A chance here for the Tigers, and they have to have it. The shot is stopped. Good save again by Madison Davis. Yana Gerber. Now LMU can just hang on to the ball as Volpizzi comes out to snag it. Pacific still forcing turnovers. But just haven't got a lot today offensively. As Futurian's shot is blocked by Davis. As Futurian continues to be kind of snake bit. 4.5 to play. Ball stays with LMU. And all the way across for Scylla to Polu. An offensive foul. And Pacific swims the other way. Skip shot off and a crossbar, and again, there's another example. Breaks just not going Pacific's way. That was a big drive from Utah's. A brilliant shot that skipped off the crossbar, but just didn't drift the way they wanted it. So it's a Polu across. Approaching the 3.5 minute mark. As Pacific takes back. Now loose ball. And a foul on that Tiger up the pool. And that was Falvey. Falvey just trying to make something happen there. The offensive foul gives the ball right back to LMU. So that's a Pulu. Once again, Pacific sends a couple of cherry pickers up the pool. And a shot clock violation. But that's just fine as far as LMU's concerned. Shot goes over the net, but stays with Pacific. 2:38 to play. Duarte. And exclusion.
Exclusion called on LMU, number 4.
So Williams goes off, it's her second. And timeout called.
We have a timeout called by Pacific.
That's Pacific's last timeout. Well, they're just going for broke now. They got to score on this power play. And even then, lots of work to do even after that. Game's been tied twice. There's been one lead change. LMU opened the scoring. A penalty throw goal from Scylla to Polu. Pacific scored back-to-back goals from Falvey. But then the aforementioned 5 straight goals from LMU to make it 6-2. And they have kept themselves at arm's length ever since. So LMU all set. You have to think Pacific's looking for a quick shot here. Futurian heads off. A 2:29 left, 31 seconds on the shot clock. Pacific's eighth power play, they're 0 for 7. Shot off the crossbar and out of play. That's exactly what Pacific wanted. Quick shot from Martinez Duamro, who's got a cannon. Another shot that does not go Pacific's way, though. Williams, the hat trick today. Just guards the ball from Davis. And Williams again swims ahead. 15. Well, it's a 3-on-3 in the offensive zone for LMU. Pacific sending more players back and just dump it into the corner. 1:50 to go. A good steal by Stella Topolu. Stella Topolu all the way across. All LMU wants to do now is just hang on to the ball. So they have pretty much all but wrapped up a spot in the championship game. Arena Ruiz. Just plays it all the way across. A 1:10 to play. Here's an open look for Martinez Duamro, and she scores.
Pacific call number 10, Ana Martinez Duamro.
Ana Martinez Duamro, her second of the game. It's a little closer at 104. After we saw 11 goals in the first half, just four here in the second half. That's the way LMU's wanted to play it, though. LMU again just plays it into the corner. Shot clock turned off, 29 ticks to go. One more look for Pacific. Utah's. And Davis a shot, and that's stopped by Madison Davis. Loyola Marymount. What a game. They power their way to a 10-5 victory. They are back in the championship game for the first time since 2019.
Congratulations to LMU for advancing to tomorrow.
So LMU advances to the championship game. Are they going to play the winner of Fresno State and San Diego State coming up next?
San Diego State at 4 p.m.
So LMU, just a terrific performance today on both sides of the ball. And they advance to the championship game. So stay tuned, 4 p.m. It's the second semifinal, Fresno State against San Diego State. So long for now from Riverside.